I wanted to lay this bill out. It's going to be acceptable to the author, but it relates to our border security strategies. As all of you know, Texas shares a 1,254-mile international border with Mexico, which is about 64% of the entirety of the U.S.-Mexico border. And so beginning in fiscal year 2005, the state began to supplement border security efforts. And the first efforts were named Operation Linebacker and Operation Rio Grande, Operation Wrangler. And they were funded by grants awarded to the Criminal Justice Division of the Governor's Office. After that, in 2008, we began to make a larger commitment to border security. So we initiated Operation Border Star, which appropriated $110 million for border security. In the 81st session, the state price tag on border security increased to $120 million. And then in the 82nd session, we increased it to $222 million. The 83rd, we went on another $510 million. And in the 84th, $800 million. In the 85th, we continued border funding at approximately $800 million. So all in, the taxpayer support for the Border for Security effort has been $2.6 billion since 2008, over the last 11 years. And I wanted to set that out just to provide some context, especially for the new members who may not appreciate the history of the border security funding. What I'd like to do, and I've had this conversation with Republicans and Democrats alike, is understand from DPS what does success mean? What is return on investment with respect to this $2.6 plus billion dollars? And so we are going to allow them through this this mechanism, and there's a study that's already called for in the bill, we're going to allow them to quantify outcomes. Tell us, hey, what we should be looking at as policymakers to determine what the return on investment of the border security strategy is, what success looks like and what victory looks like, and how we might be able to categorize an ongoing effort and investment in this strategy. So today we don't have those answers, and I'm really grateful that Chairman Zerwas has called for a study in this bill, because we need to have a perspective and an understanding whether these $2.6 billion are too little, or whether they're too much, or whether they're just right. And we need to be able to benchmark against deliverables and quantifiable outcomes. So with that, members, I just wanted to provide that brief history and thank Chairman Zerwas for working with me on this amendment, and I move adoption.
Mr. Anchia offers up an amendment. It's acceptable to the author. Mr. Kane has requested a record vote on the accepting of the amendment. The clerk will please ring the bell. Show Mr. Anchia voting aye, Ms. Longoria voting aye. Show Mr. Zerwas voting aye. All members voted. Show Mr. Leach voting aye. Mr. Bell voting aye. Have all voted. There being 82 ayes and 61 nays, the amendment is adopted.